Everyone has your drink?
Yes.
So I'm going to have my drink poured and then we'll get started, okay?
Okay.
Wow.
Virtually.
I mean, her drink being poured.
Where you get that white hand from?
There I have it.
Where you get the white hand pouring the drink?
Somebody there's doing it for me. We are okay. White people up here too, you know. Okay. All right. So I got my drink. All right. Got my drink. So we got to get ready to begin. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, this morning, we come on another Wednesday morning. It's all because of your grace and your mercy. You watched over each of us as we slept last night. And again, you have allowed us to be awakened in our right minds. We no longer take breathing for granted. We no longer take life for granted. And so this morning, we just bow with humble gratitude just to say thank you for giving us life again on this new day. Thank you for all the provisions you have given to us. Thank you for calling us to this special time where we as a group of women from various backgrounds can come together just to talk a little, to laugh a little, and to learn a little. Bless each family represented here. Continue to keep the blood on the doorpost of every home and every heart. Where there's need of healing, be it spiritual, be it physical, be it emotional, be it financial or social. Right now, Lord, I ask that you would place your hand on each woman and supply the need that she stands in need of. You are welcome in our meeting now, we pray. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
All right, today is the 20th day of the month of... The month of May. I thought you were sleeping there for a minute.
May.
The month of May, the May. 20th day on the month of May. And we are celebrating our pre-Memorial and pre-Jamaica's Labor Day celebration, hence the two flags behind me. And I'm celebrating. Those who didn't get, I'm celebrating. You didn't see? I'm celebrating. All right.
Okay.
I'm celebrating. And we are not only I'm having a pre-celebration, we want to celebrate all the new guests, all the new participants who are with us this morning. So if you have been an ambassador this week, let's see who you are, and then you will tell us who you bought, and then they in turn will introduce themselves. Okay, Ambassador Diane is smiling up there saying, pick me, pick me, pick me. Go on.
I'm one of my parents from this one of the students that I teach, Mrs. Fayanne Forbes.
Oh, singing Miss Jones. That's a lovely voice you got there.
Thank you.
You're hiding your talent.
Okay, welcome Fayon. Okay, they must not be hearing me.
Hi, my name is Yvonne Adley. I'm on.
Okay, go on.
And I'd like to say good morning to all the lovely ladies.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning. And good welcome, morning. Yvonne. Welcome.
Hi,
We can't see you. What happened, Yvonne? You're in the darkness? Okay, go on, Gwen. I'm sorry.
Hi, my name is Gwen Gibson from Bahamas, and I'd like to say hello to everybody.
Hello.
Hello, Gwen, hello. And welcome.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Okay. So let's give a round of applause to all those joining us for the first time. Let's go. Welcome. Okay, so welcome to our Let's Talk. And this morning we want to give a shout out to all graduates. So if you have anybody in your house or family members who have graduated, and we are not just talking about college grad, because I have my little grandson finished preschool, getting older. So you have from K, maybe they have completed elementary, maybe they have completed high school, maybe they have completed college, big giant step, or even university. We want to say from Let's Talk, congratulations. Let's give a shout out to the grads. Congratulations. So let's drink to the grads. Come on, get your glasses and get a sip to the graduates. That was good. I'll hear what you are drinking. I did say non-alcoholic, so make sure you, okay? Make sure you follow.
Drunk.
So I'm going to find out. Don't worry, I'm going to find out in a minute what it is you are drinking. Okay, I'm drinking lemonade. All right.
Yeah.
Have you been using your words? I hope that as you segued from your mundane tasks, your household tasks, your jobs, that this week you've been very fastidious, even as the islands and the states are opening up. Remember to be fastidious. This pandemic has not gone any place, so practice being fastidious. And I'm so glad you had an appetency to join us again this morning. You made a sagacious choice when you came on this morning. So welcome. And I know sometimes during the week you have enjoyed the Zephyr. And in fact, I see people like Christine and those, they are wearing Zephyr this morning. And so welcome again to Let's Talk. Joe Diane, you wanted me to say you are wearing Zephyr too? Yes, I see you. I saw you fixing like, see me, so I saw you. I saw you. Yes, you're wearing Zephyr. Okay, Nasa, are you ready for a new word? I hope you've been using your vocab. Get your pen and paper ready. New word of the week. Plethora. That's P-L-E-T-H-O-R-A, plethora. It is a noun. It means a large or excessive amount of something. When you have too much of something, you have a plethora. Let's say the word together, plethora.
Plethora. Plethora. Plethora.
Again, plethora.
Plethora.
Okay, when you have a too much, a large or an excessive amount of anything, you have a plethora because it is a noun. Now remember, before we are finished, you need to make sure you use that noun, that word, before you leave. So while you speak to me, try to get it in so you don't have to always be at the end. So, plethora. I know that Joe Diane and Jenilyn have a plethora of mangoes and they're not sharing with me. A plethora. I know they have it.
Not excess.
I know you do. Okay. Now, let's go to our health tip and see what Dr. Rianne has for us this morning.
Good day, everyone. My name is Rianne Jones, final year medical student, back with your weekly health tip. Last week, we spoke about the common cold, how it is transmitted, symptoms, how to prevent, and treatment. This week, we will be discussing a few myths about the common cold. Next week, we'll be comparing the common cold with other similar illnesses such as influenza and COVID-19. True or false? Myth number one, I have a really bad sore throat and a fever, so I definitely need an antibiotic. False. A sore throat can be caused by a virus or bacteria. If it is caused by a virus, as we mentioned last week, antibiotics won't help. Fever is simply the immune system fighting the infection and does not mean it is caused by a bacteria. The good news is that if it is viral, the infection will resolve on its own. You can treat symptoms with lozenges, warm tea with honey, my personal favorite, salt water gargles, and acetaminophen or ibuprofen. Myth number two, I had a runny nose for a few days and the mucus has turned a really nasty color. Time for antibiotics. False. In the past, green or yellow mucus was the justification for giving someone an antibiotic. As a result, antibiotics have been overused and multiple strains of bacteria have developed a resistance. Some of these are now superbugs, which are very difficult to treat and actually may be life-threatening. Instead of signaling the need to call in reinforcements, The color change is a sign your immune system is just doing its job. The color of the mucus is really just a reflection of the battle that the immune system is waging against the virus or bacteria. In fact, any chronic inflammation, such as poorly controlled allergies, can result in thick colored mucus. Often, when you start noticing the change in mucus, the end of your cold is approaching. Myth number three. My kid went outside wearing shorts in the middle of January. He'll catch his death of cold. Probably false. So you've heard them all before from your mother when you're a kid, and you may have even told your kids the same thing. But the truth is, you're no less likely to catch a cold if you're warm and dry indoors than if you're wet and cold outside. A long time ago, before we knew about microscopic organisms such as bacteria and viruses, we needed to come up with an explanation for why people became sick. Things like exposure to elements were commonly blamed. Now we know that in order to catch a cold, you have to be exposed to one of the hundreds of viruses known to cause colds. But that doesn't mean your mother was on the wrong track when she told you to wear your coat. In general, going outside in the cold without a coat or with wet hair does not make someone ill. But prolonged exposure to harsh elements could weaken the immune system somewhat, making the person more susceptible to illness if they are exposed to an infectious agent. This concludes this week's discussion on the common cold. See you next week, where we'll be comparing symptoms of the common cold with other similar illnesses.
Okay, thank you again, Rayan. Very timely and a lot of information and dispelling many of the myths that we have. So let's drink to the young doctor. Let's go. Good stuff. All right, ready for our tech tip.
Hello, good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Well, today, our tech tip for today is, again, it's going to be simple. We work from simple all the way up to more advanced things. Most of us on the call use WhatsApp. It's a messaging application that allows us to contact and communicate with people all around the world. And we've done a few things in WhatsApp so far. Can anyone tell me one of the things that we've learned with WhatsApp, one of the tips or tricks? You can shout it out.
Fasting.
One more time.
I'll just do another blast.
That's right, a broadcast, exactly. So what we're going to do now is we're going to switch over to changing and updating our either our wallpaper or actually our profile picture. These are really simple things to do, but again, not too many people will do it. The profile picture just allows you to have a really nice picture of you, yourself, your family, or something that you love. And it allows for people who are communicating with you to not have to either save the phone number to their address book in order to recognize the number. They can simply just look at the picture and say, oh, that's exactly who I want to communicate with. So to change a picture in WhatsApp, it's very simple. Here are the steps. In the top right corner of your WhatsApp application, you will see three vertical dots, one stacked on top of the other. Once you tap that, you will see about five options. New group, new broadcast, which we spoke about before, WhatsApp, have it, starred messages, if you have it. But last, but certainly not least, settings. So once you select settings from that three-dot vertical option in the top right corner of your WhatsApp application, It will bring up your name with a few options underneath. One is account, the other is chats, notifications, so on and so forth. To change or add a picture that if you've never had a picture there before, is really simple. Where you see your name at the top of the screen, simply tap the circle to the left of your name. If you have a picture there, simply tap the picture that's to the left of your name. Once you tap the picture, it will magnify the picture just a little bit more, and now you're able to see the name that you have, your phone number, and any message that you would like to put in the about field. To change the picture, on the actual picture itself, you will see in the bottom right corner of that circle, an icon that looks like a camera. Once you tap the camera, it will ask you, where would you like your profile photo to come from? Do you want to take a brand new picture, or do you want to go to your gallery and get a picture from there? You have those two options, where you can take a new, brand new picture, or if you have a favorite picture that you would like to display, you can simply select gallery. Once you choose one of those options, you will be allowed to find the picture or pictures that you would like. Once you select the picture, simply hit done. And that's it. You will change your profile picture. It's that simple. Again, you go to the top right, you go to settings, you select the picture or circle to the left of your name, you select the camera icon, and you choose your camera if you want to take a brand new picture, or you choose from your gallery if you have a picture that you like. The other option is changing your wallpaper. The wallpaper is simply when you're texting or chatting with anyone, you would like a certain background to the actual chat box that you like. It can be clouds, it can be stars, it can be whatever you would like it to be. It's simply the same thing. You go to the top right, you go to settings, and in this time, you're not going to select the picture to the left of your name, you simply go down to where the header says chats. Once you select chats, it allows you to change your wallpaper because there is at the top display and it says, do you want to change wallpaper? So you select the word wallpaper. And it will give you the same options primarily. It will give you your gallery where all of your photos are stored. It would ask you if you want it to be a solid color, red, black, white, blue, whatever you prefer. Or if you have any pictures or images in your WhatsApp library, you can select WhatsApp library or wallpaper library, and it will show you all the different ones that you have. Once you find the photo that you would like to have as your chat background, simply select it, simply say done. And from there forward, anytime you talk to someone or you're chatting with someone, that wallpaper will be displayed in the background. So let me see, hopefully that was simple enough. You just went over two things, and so I'm going to actually do a little quiz on that. First question is, what did we talk about today? What were the two main things we learned today? Let's see if you want to raise your hand, feel free. If you want to raise your hand, actually, okay, there we go. I see Miss Diane. You take one, Miss Diane, and Janelyn, you take the other. Miss Diane, one of the two things.
You take your profile picture, or to add a profile picture.
Perfect. And then, Angelin, what would be the second?
Using a wallpaper.
All right. Changing the wallpaper. I'm going to actually call on someone. It's going to be a softball question so that you won't feel too nervous. But let me call on someone real quick. Miss Cash, I have a question for you. where do you go to change either your wallpaper or change your profile picture? It starts with an S. What is that term or field called?
Settings. Settings.
That's right. You got it. Thank you very much. All right. Let's see. Shanique, here's a question for you. When you go to settings and you would like to change your wallpaper, which of the three options would you select? Would you select account, chats, or notifications?
You would, so to change the wallpaper, you would select chats.
Perfect, very good, very good. And here is the last question that I'm going to throw out there. Christine, I'll ask you a question. When you would like to change your profile picture, Christine, you will select the small circle or picture to the left of your name. And where do you go next to actually choose the picture you would like to change?
You can either go into your gallery
or
your picture store.
That's right. You will go into your gallery all the way, and to get to your gallery, you will select the little camera icon that is on the bottom right of the circle or the picture itself. So hopefully that was easy enough, right? Hopefully that wasn't too difficult. I encourage you all as an exercise to try, just do a new picture. Change a picture, add a picture, update a picture. Try one of those three things this week in your WhatsApp and hopefully you can get comfortable with it. And then we'll move to another tech tip in the future. That is my tech tip for today.
Okay, let's give a round of applause to our tech tip. Let's take a little drink. He works very hard getting us sorted out here. To Kyle. All right, let's go. Refreshing. Okay, now we have our recipe, which was sent to us by Domika. Okay, she sent in cinnamon rolls. I know most of us like cinnamon rolls. So there is a recipe for cinnamon rolls, including not only the dough, but the filling, the icing, and of course, the instructions of how to make those delicious looking cinnamon rolls. You will be receiving that recipe shortly after we are finished here on the show. So thank you, Domika, for sending in your cinnamon roll recipe. And now, Jenna Lynn, are you ready? We do a little laughing. Laughter is medicine. Now, she makes me laugh every time I talk to her. She needs to make us all laugh today. What you do for me bawling over? So let's go.
I am laughing by myself from now. That's a joke, right?
Yes.
Now, I'm going to tell you about an elderly couple, Maisie and Albert. They were married for long, 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 and I think they were happy, very happy couple. And Albert, especially, I know he had a plethora of love for Maisie. So one day he said, Maisie, you know, after all these years, I still have a lot of love for you. You know, Maisie smiled. And she said, before I tell you what she said, both of them had a hearing problem. They were up in age and things going down on them. They had a hearing problem. So when he said, you know, Maisie, you know, I have a tour of love for you. After all these years, I love you so much, still love you so much. So she smiled and she said, Albert, You know, after all these years, I am tired of you too.
Yeah, that was funny. So that was funny. Okay, now the part you were waiting for, to tell me what you did with all these t-shirts that you have on. Let's begin up there with Christine. T-shirts and research. T-shirts and research. Tell me about your t-shirts.
I'm gonna stand up so you can see my t-shirt.
All right.
It was a little tedious. I had to do a lot of brainstorming. And then I said, oh, it's nice. It's going to be hot, so why not get a sleeveless shirt? And I got me a flag. It's a little paper flag. I really wanted a cloth one. And I got some stickers, you see, and stick on the Jamaica. And I put the date on. The day down the bottom, Jamaica Day. And then I did the same thing for the back. Memorial Day. And then I was so proud of myself. I'm telling you, I didn't know I could do this great artistry. I did a wonderful job. I was very proud.
I am proud of you.
Thank you.
You mentioned about your artistry with your t-shirt. You didn't tell me about learning your facts. Was that difficult or easy?
Learning my what? I didn't hear.
Your facts.
Learning my
facts on Memorial Day and Labor Day.
Oh, yes, that was pretty good. Well, I'm a Jamaican, so I really have an idea of what Labor Day is all about there. And I learned about Labor Day in America, which was very good, which was sort of similar. I picked up the similarity, which Ms. Spence had mentioned earlier, that how, and it took me a while because I was, not took me a while, but I was really like, how did she really come up with this, you know? So it took, the research was really good in getting deeper knowledge or depth into the information.
Okay, Sharon, what about you, Cash?
Well, I didn't know that much about Labor Day in Jamaica, and I didn't know much about Memorial Day in the US. So I went online and did some research, and I didn't know that on Labor Day, Jamaicans actually did work in their constituencies to help beautify. That's a fact that I did learn. But another fact was that the then Prime Minister, Michael Manley, had replaced Empire Day, which we also celebrated here in the Bahamas, with Labor Day. That was one thing I did not know. And then Memorial Day, well, I didn't know that they celebrated Memorial Day. Their first celebration was all the way back in 1868. That was... I really was shocked because I really didn't know that one.
All right, Naomi.
I had a bit of difficulty in trying to decide exactly what I should do in reference to these holidays. I asked a friend of mine who was an American about their Memorial Day. And she didn't tell me very much. She said to me, go and say hello to Google and say what you want and you'll find out. So I went on Google.
That's a good one.
And I, the facts that I found out about it, I got it from Google.
All right.
Jamaica.
What about your t-shirt?
Pardon?
Your t-shirt.
Oh.
What about your t-shirt?
You want me to stand up now?
That's your choice.
Are you able to see me?
Yes.
I'm seeing you. Wow.
You shut? Are you seeing the bottom part of it or not?
Don't touch that phone. Don't touch that phone.
It's a skirt.
Yes. Waffles.
Okay.
Yeah, beautiful.
I didn't have any materials at home, so I was able to get this from a friend of mine. And I told her what I wanted to do. And so she suggested that I use the colors of the flag for Jamaica. And I found out, like Ms. Kef said earlier, that Jamaicans actually go out and they physically labor on Labor Day for the decorations, maybe paint a school, paint the walkway, or whatever manual labor they can do. And I think that was quite interesting because it's so different from what we are accustomed to. We are accustomed to parades and all of that, but they work.
All right, thank you, Jalita. Unmute your phone.
I think every state in America had different for Labor Day because I also checked the internet and they said Labor Day was created by a labor movement in the late 19th century and it became a federal holiday in 1894. Then that was in, I think, in Alabama.
Okay.
I can remember that. And that's my point.
Thank you. Okay, Marlene.
Okay. Getting started was a bit rough for me, especially in creating my flights for my activity actually for the Labor Day in Jamaica and for the Memorial Day in America. Everything that I thought of doing, I didn't have any material at home to complete it. Everything was at my store. But because I'm so tied up into sewing, I started looking through the house for pieces of material. And I came up with the idea of making the flag. So I just cut the strips of material and I made the flag for Jamaica. I stitched it onto a t-shirt. And I made the flag for America and stitched it at the back. And so that was my project completed. Now with the facts of Jamaica and America, well, Jamaica was quite interesting. I didn't know that they usually labor on Labor Day, like go around and build houses or paint or do this and that sort of stuff, which is very interesting. I thought they used to do the same thing that we do home here. Have fun. Just have Junkunu rush out and go and just have fun. But that was quite interesting. I think we need to take a pattern from them. And in America, well, where they honor the persons who died, I learned that they honor the persons who died in the military and stuff like that, and that was quite good. But I learned a lot of facts from reading through. The Memorial Day in America and the Labor Day in Jamaica.
Okay, good. In lieu of time, you're going to hear more about the facts on our video. So just tell us in 1 minute, the rest of you about your t-shirt because the facts will come up shortly. All right, Ivy, t-shirt.
Okay, what I did my research before I did the t-shirt. I must admit I was not fastidious in doing my project, but in doing the research, I came up with, when they talk about that Memorial Day and taking flowers to the grave, flowers or wreaths or flags, that's how I came up with the idea to do the flowers, and to the bottom, these little rhinestones, they're supposed to be the grass in the graveyard where the flowers are placed during Memorial Day in the US. And then when I researched Jamaica and I saw what they do on Labor Day with the buildings and beautification of the place, I said, but I cannot draw a building. So I said, well, the flowers, the same flowers, can be the beautification that they would do around the various places in Jamaica. So that's what I came up with, and trying to keep in with what I had in the house at the time. That's why the colors are so dull, because that's all the paint that I had in my house at the time.
Okay, Janilyn, 1 minute about your t-shirt.
Okay, my t-shirt. As you can see, I have here the 25th. I put the 25th in the middle, and I this is to divide it in two, half for Jamaica and half for USA. We said it's USA Memorial Day. I find it very difficult to even remember the name of the day, Memorial Day. And I learned just what it is all about. But Jamaica Day, I couldn't find anything new to learn. But what I learned was that for this year, the theme, because every year you have a theme, whether you're going to do community, you're going to do streets, or you're going to do schools, the theme is work at home. And so I got this picture of the man washing his car. See? Washing and get to iron it on and all of that. And the Jamaican and the USA flag printed on. And in the back, I had two messages. One for Jamaica is saying, work at home. And one for USA is saying, remember and honor.
All right.
Love it.
1 minute. Tell us about your making your t-shirt.
Who's that?
Danique. Kayla.
Oh, okay. I'm sorry about that. So what I did, I just hand painted on the two flags. And in caption, I put, welcome to Labor Day. And then at the bottom, I put celebrating Memorial Day, both May 25th, 2020. And that's about it.
Okay, that was nice and short. Margaret?
Hi. What I did was, I put America on one side and Jamaica on the other side, and I put Memorial at the bottom, Labor, and on the outside, I put Jamaica, and I put USA, and then around on the front, at the top, I would just put the date, and I did all of it in sequence.
Okay.
The majority of them dropped off, and I had to do it again before putting it on. But it was good. The facts were good, and the one thing I wanted to say was, I didn't know that it was Queen Victoria who actually granted slavery, the emancipation in Jamaica. So I was happy of that. And then her birthday was the day they did the Empire Day was her birthday. So she was the one who was responsible for fighting behind the background. So I was proud to learn that it was a woman.
All right, so Diane.
Okay, what I did was I went online to get some picture ideas of how to decorate t-shirt in connection with the Memorial Day and the Labor Day. And for the most part, for the Labor Day part of it, I saw a lot of persons just working, and I said I didn't really want to use that, although that's what Labor Day really signifies for Jamaica. So what I did was I took pictures really from offline. I printed it and I just pasted a lot of pictures onto a t-shirt for Memorial Day. And for Labor Day, I highlighted most of things indicative to Jamaica culture. So.
That's good, that's good.
That is what I did.
I like it. All
right, Sharon Taylor.
My t-shirt, I really wanted to do a tie-dye, but materials and time didn't allow me because I didn't start in sufficient time. So I simplified it by just painting on a circle of United States with Memorial Day and the date and the flag. And in the back of it, I hope everyone can see me because I'm just using my phone.
Yes.
The Jamaican flag with Jamaica and Labor Day and the date, the similarity between the two, the date, which is the 25th.
Okay, Donita. Unmute your mic.
All right. Good day, everybody. Well, I made a plethora of errors while designing my t-shirt. First and foremost, I didn't know anything. I'm a Guyanese, so I didn't know anything about the U.S. Memorial Day, and I don't know anything about Jamaica's Labor Day. So everything for me was new, and then I wasn't even there last week. So what I did, I have a friend who's a Jamaican. So I called her up and I said, listen, I need some information about Jamaica's Labor Day. And she sent me a voice note with all the details that I needed. And then living on Kent Island and trying to find materials for stuff like this, that's almost impossible. So what I had in the home was a flag of Jamaica, a little flag. On a stick. I took it off the stick and I glued it to the shirt. And then I got my husband to actually draw the flag of the United States.
All right.
And these are the stars are actually what I use in school to give my students the motivation. And then the teacher and me came out and I just wrote on the shirt, Happy Memorial. And the L from the memorial come down, Labor Day. That's my shirt.
All right.
Good.
Okay, good. Diane, are you ready? This is the first one to complete a project.
Yes, here's my shirt. So I got excited and I started wondering what I was going to do while we were still in last week's session.
Oh.
So after, I didn't have any t-shirts, so I used the shirt I had, and I started painting. So I painted the chain, broken chain, because Labor Day, the rebellion from it, led to the country gaining its independence. So that's what that was all about. And Memorial Day, it got its name in 1971. It was first called Decoration Day. So I had the year 1971, I have the shield and spear. I was trying to go for the whole military look, but I'm not very artistic, so that's all I could manage to paint. And that was my shirt. I was very excited about this project. And yes!
Yes! Let's drink to Joe Diane. The last shall become first.
Well, we know how that happened.
No. Don't you say that, Dan.
How did that happen?
She had put out her disclaimer, so I don't know why she's responding.
Right.
And now, since you all had to do research on Memorial Day, you are now going to get a quiz. Have your paper and pen ready.
Just a minute, Dan.
Everyone that you get right, just put a tally mark for it and let's see if you can find the answer to it. Somebody is complaining.
Just a minute, Blanche.
Finger up already?
No, I need to say something.
Make it
May
quick.
I? Okay, very quickly.
Second.
Okay, just to tell everybody that Labor Day is really the 23rd of May, and we Jamaicans take it so seriously. Yes. My daughter was born on Labor Day, and I was born on Labor Day also. And it's a public holiday, so I'm always at home and enjoying it.
Wonderful.
I have a question. I didn't get to display my shirt.
Oh, yes, Yvonne, go on. See you in the darkness. We can't see you. Come on.
That's all right. I'm ready. I can see everybody. Hi, good afternoon. My voice, I'm going to
go on.
I'm going to play some fat with Jamaica, which is a tropical country. You can see on my shirt, I display the coconut.
See, we can't see you,
I will tell you what's on it. I have my shirt, the coconut tree, which is a part of the tropical plant of Jamaica. And of course, here, Labor Day was where Queen Victoria granted the freedom of slaves. And actually, what they do, they abolish her birthday, and instead, they place Labor Day in honor of Queen Victoria, and is celebrated as a national holiday in Jamaica.
Okay, thank you. Are you ready for your quiz? Just put a tally mark when you get it correct, because these are just true or false questions. So let's get it on and get it decided. True or false questions, that's all they are. Another, number one, another name for Memorial Day was Decoration Day. True or false? Put your hand up. Ooh. No, don't say it out. Put your hand up if you think it's true. And if your hand's down, it means it's false. So that's all I'm asking. Hands up if you think that is true. Another name for Memorial Day was Decoration Day.
Let's see my hand?
You are right. What do you say, true or false? True. So if your hand was up for true, give yourself a tally mark.
Do you see my hand?
Well, I'm going to believe it was up, okay? I'm going to trust you. You're grading your own paper. Number two.
I thought you were putting it up virtually, Blanche.
Number two. Anyone you want to do. Yes, anyone. Anyone. Number two. We honor presidents on Memorial Day. True or false? Put your hand up if you say that's true. And the answer is
false.
So if your hand was down, it honors fallen soldiers, not presidents. So give yourself a tally mark if you got that correct. Number three, the tomb of the unknown soldier is found at the Arlington National Cemetery. The tomb of the unknown soldier is found at the Arlington National Cemetery. Put your hands up if you say it's true. If your hand is up, it means it's true. Let's see if you are correct. And the answer to that is true. So if you had your hand up, give yourself a tally mark. Number four, Memorial Day was first observed in Chattanooga, Tennessee. Is that true or false? If you say it's true, put your hand up. Okay, let's see the answer to that. That is false. It was in Waterloo, New York. So if you got that correct, then give yourself a tally mark. Number five. Labor Day in Jamaica is the same as Independence Day. True or false? If you say it's true, put your hand up. Okay, let's see the answer to that. That's false. If you got that correct, give yourself a tally mark. Number six. Empire Day was the birthday of Queen Victoria. True or false? Put your hand up if you say that's true. Okay, let's see what your answer is. The answer is, that's true. If you got that correct, put your tally mark. And the last one, number 7. The last one. Michael Manley was the one who changed Empire Day to Labor Day. True or false? Put your hand up if you say that's true. Okay, and the answer is?
True.
False. It was the right, it's his dad, the right excellent Norman Washington Manley.
Oh.
Okay, it was his daddy. All right, tally up. Well, you should have gotten 7 out of 7. Mm. All that studying you did.
Mm.
Shall I ask or shall I leave it like that? Shall I ask? Nobody's leave responding.
Leave it, I said, leave it.
Leave it like that. You don't want to tell me you got 100.
I got 5.
I got 6. Let's drink to new knowledge. That was new knowledge. Good. Let's take a drink. That was good. So sip on your drink now while you watch yourselves.
The drink is finished.
Oh, well, think about the taste of your drink while you watch yourselves. Okay, video time.
Here sharing the 2 things I learned, one of Memorial Day and of Independence Day. So Memorial Day was first called Decoration Day and it started in 1971. And Labor Day in Jamaica was as a result of a labor rebellion which pushed the country into independence, hence my broken shackles.
The 25th of May is celebrated in Jamaica and in the USA. In the USA it is Memorial Day and in Jamaica it is Labor Day. Labor Day is a special day, it's a public holiday and all communities get involved in community projects. For USA, they celebrate the veterans, those who gave their life. It's a special day. Thank you.
You may ask, why does Jamaica celebrate Labor Day? Well, Norman Washington Manley was the one who proposed changing Empire State Day, that is, the celebration of Queen Victoria's birthday, to Labor Day. And then, why do we celebrate Memorial Day here in the U.S.? It's because of the Civil War. There was so much loss that many communities got together to lay wreaths on the graves of the soldiers. And because of that, New York City became the first city to celebrate Memorial Day.
In Jamaica, Labor Day replaced Empire Day. In America, the first Labor Day was celebrated on Tuesday, September 5th, 1882, in New York City.
David Halsall wrote, "The United States Memorial Day holiday was long known as Decoration Day for the practice of decorating the graves of war veterans with flowers, wreaths, and flags." Research in the jis.gov.jm shows that for 10 years, Labor Day in Jamaica was celebrated mainly in the corporate area by the trade unions in collaboration with political parties in the forms of rallies and marches.
One fact that I didn't know about Labor Day in Jamaica was that Michael Manley, the then Prime Minister, replaced Empire Day with Labor Day. One fact that I didn't know about Memorial Day in the United States was that it was first celebrated on the 30th of May, 1868.
During Jamaica Labor Day, groups, individuals, and communities used their time and dedication to improve public areas, do repairs, paint or build homes, schools, and churches. Memorial Day in the U.S. is an American holiday when men and women who died while serving in the military are honored.
Did you know that the U.S. Memorial Day is considered the official start to summer? Did you also know that Queen Victoria of England's birthday was on May 24th and was celebrated in Jamaica? But since then, her birthday has been abolished and replaced with Jamaica's Labor Day.
72, the Honorable Prime Minister of Michael Manley expressed to all Jamaicans the importance to the nation through voluntary community work. In 1971, Monday holiday law shifted Memorial Day from May 30th to the last Monday in May.
Our day isn't really a happy holiday in America. It's actually a time of reflection and remembrance of veterans, those who would have fought in war, and actually some of them who would have died during this ordeal. On Labor Day in Jamaica, it was when Queen Victoria has credited and granting the freedom of slaves. So now they celebrate her birthday, but by abolishing this, they honor it in place of and celebrate it now as Labor Day, a national holiday in Jamaica. But of course, it's all centered around the freedom of slave granted by Queen Victoria in Jamaica.
An interesting fact about Jamaica's Labor Day is that it's celebrated on May 25th, 2020, formally called Empire Day, to celebrate Queen Victoria's birthday and her emancipation of slaves in Jamaica. USA Memorial Day is also celebrated on May 25th, 2020, formally called Decoration Day, to honor fallen soldiers. People would go by their graveside to take flowers and flags and much, much more.
Labor Day has been officially recognized in Jamaica since 1960. Memorial Day was formerly known as Decoration Day and commemorated men and women who died in the military services for the United States of America.
Did you know that Jamaica's Labor Day originated back in 1938 when Alexander Bustamante fought for the rights of Jamaicans? And did you know that America's Memorial Day started to honor fallen heroes who fought in World War I? Later, America encountered World War II, and they decided to include World Wars I, II, the Vietnamese, the Korean War, and the Iraqi War. There you have it. Both days are celebrated on May 25th every year.
Memorial Day is a day dedicated to all fallen heroes of the United States wars and service. It is celebrated on the last Monday in May. And now, I segue to Jamaica. Jamaica's Labor Day is celebrated by the people giving of their time and energy towards the beautification of the communities all over the island. It is celebrated on May 23rd.
Jamaica's Labor Day is celebrated on the 23rd of May each year. During this time, or on this day, public spirited individuals and organizations showcase the true meaning of labor by actually going out into their neighborhoods and showcasing the labor by physically fixing infrastructures or whatever is broken or needs fixing in their environment or their communities. On the other hand, Memorial Day is celebrated in the United States of America on the last Monday of May each year, same week as Jamaica's Labor Day. The Memorial Day sole purpose is actually just to remember those men and women who died in the line of service while serving the country. So there you have it, folks. A little bit of this and that about Jamaica's Labor Day and America's Memorial Day.
Okay, and now we are waiting to see the second part when you did your modeling. Let's look at that.
Get a little trip, you see. We go on New York City. So me get up early one morning, gone to the embassy. Me have me car title, my bank book, and me job letter with me pay. Only man behind the window, on the look for me and say, hey, Mr. Brown, can you prove to me that you will not run away? Mr. Brown, can you prove to me that you will not overstay? Me never want to get vexed. Me just have to think what next. I said, sir, let me tell you something about myself. I have saw me lead, I have saw me go. I have saw me friend them day, I have saw me know. I have saw have sweet woman reggae music and temperature turn up right. I have saw me low, I have saw well nice. In a the line right next to me was a nice young miss, you see. Tell me, say, have a little shop and she need some things in her Miami. Well, me no know where them set to her, but it look like them get her out. Me hungry here when she kiss her teeth and then she start ball out. I have some in leave, I have some in go. I have some in friend them day, I have some in no. I have some have jerk, chicken, coconut water and food full up of spice. I have some in low. I have so well nice. In the middle of the embassy, everybody start rock with me. We sing out why we love Jamaica eternally. We tell them about roots, breadfruit, bulla and pear. All kind of fruits are ripe through the air. Mountains, rivers, warm sea water. Good school fee me son and me daughter. And when our time for your fun, everything turn up, vibes can't done. I have so well, nice. I have so me leave, I have so me go. I have so me friend them day, I have so me know. I have so name Jamaica, Jamaica. Jamaica suit me just right, I have so me love. I have so well nice, I have so me leave. I have so me go. I have saw me friend them day, I have saw me know. I have saw them Jamaica, Jamaica. Jamaica suit me just right, I have saw me love. I have saw well nice, I have saw me love. I have saw well nice, I have saw me love. I have saw well nice, I have saw me love. I have saw well nice, I have saw me love. I am so well nice.
Okay, wow, that was fun, eh?
Yes, it was.
Yes, so you will be receiving all of that so you could let it marinate, okay? And you now have a plethora of knowledge about Memorial Day and Jamaica's Labor Day.
And you have a plethora of fun to see us make up.
Yes, we did. Some didn't know they had those moves.
And you have a plethora of talent in this
room. Yes, that's for sure. That is certain. So Listen, good job, ladies. Give yourselves a round of applause. Good job. And each one was different. That's what I enjoy about these projects as I watch them come in. Each one is different to see our thought processes, and you are doing an excellent job. You're learning and you're having fun. That's the key.
Well, it's all because of you.
Well, it's because of God working.
Yes, but God, you're allowing the Lord to use you to bring out the best in us. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Okay, let's look now. Let's unpack one verse, Psalm 27, verse 4. One verse we are unpacking. Psalm 27, verse 4. Remember, as we unpack, we go forward and we tie and include. Now, we talked in verses 1, 2, and 3 about the Lord being our light and our salvation. We talked about not being afraid, even when our foes or enemies come against us. So let's see what verse 4 is saying. It begins with a numerical word. What is that?
One.
One. What does one mean to you?
And
singular. What does it mean?
Singular.
Singular. Okay. So you're not asking for much. When you ask for one, you're not asking for much. And it's not the Jamaican one. When they tell you they're giving you one mango, you normally get 2, 3, 4, 5.
Yeah.
I do know that. I like their one. But the psalmist David is just talking about one thing. He's only focused singular on one thing. One thing. Undivided aim. Focused. Tunnel vision. Only one thing. He's not all over the place that I want this, that. Just one request, one thing. And notice he's asking for himself. Like we learn, you need to make sure yourself, you are emotionally, physically, whatever, able before you can help somebody else. You need to make sure you strengthen yourself. So one thing, I, talking about himself. And then what verb does he use?
Desire.
He's asking. So it's from, the one thing is from, and whom is he asking this one thing from?
The Lord.
Go back to verse 1. Which Lord is he talking about?
The Lord is our light.
We talked about that. This request, one thing he wants is from the Lord, the one which gives light, the one who dispels darkness. We visited that before. Which Lord again? The one who is my light
and my salvation.
And he's also our salvation, the one who can save us. Not only save us from our sins. Yes, go on, Janelyn.
The one who gives me strength.
That's right. So this salvation, this savior is not only from our sins, he's saving us during this pandemic.
Yeah.
So he's saving us emotionally, saving us physically, saves us spiritually, economically, socially. This is the Lord. His request is for this one thing from the Lord, the one who is my light and my salvation. And now he makes a request of the Lord. Let's look and see what this request is.
I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days.
What is the request?
To dwell with the Lord.
To dwell. What it means to dwell.
To live with.
To live with. When you dwell with somebody, you live with them.
And
he says he wants to live with them. You know, it's not easy to live with everybody. Sometimes it's not easy to live with our own family members. In this pandemic, some people, they call it cabin fever. They want to get away from each other. It's just too much of you now. I need some space. But his request is he wants to live with the Lord. He wants to live with the Lord where?
In his house.
He wants to live with him in his house. And how is he going to live with him? It's up on our board. He's going to live with him through what?
Fellowship and communion.
Communion and fellowship.
Communion and fellowship. So they're going to have a conversation. One is listening.
Mommy, your hot dog on the phone.
No.
Okay. Someone is adding something. Okay. So he's going to do this through communion and fellowship with the Lord.
Yeah.
That's what he's doing this. They're going to have a good time together.
Hello?
And somebody's adding. Okay. And then it says, for how long?
All the days of my life.
All the days.
All the days of my life.
With the Lord.
All the days,
all the days, of, days of my life.
Oh, that's a long time to stay with somebody. So you have to be in love with that person to want to stay with them all the days of your life. That is some serious love for the Lord. If we could get there, all of our troubles would be gone emotionally. We won't have to worry about anything because we know this God of light and salvation, as we commune and fellowship with him, he's going to take care of us totally. And this was his request. I want to just stay in your presence all the days of my life. To do what? What is he going to do all the days of his life in his presence? What it says? What's the first thing he's going to do?
Behold the beauty of the Lord.
Okay, my voice says to gaze upon the Lord's beauty. What it means when you gaze at something or someone?
Stare.
Behold.
It's not really a stare. A stare and a gaze are two different. They have a little bit.
Be captivated by.
Ah, that's it, Joe Diane. When you gaze, you are enraptured. You stand in awe. Your mouth is open because it's so beautiful. You just want to, you know, just stay there. Whereas a stare could be one of hate. You know, when you say, I stare somebody down. This is not that. This is, you are enraptured when you gaze at the Lord's beauty and you see what he has done for you, what he's doing for you. You are enamored, you are in awe. So that is one of the things David says he wants to do. All the days of my life, I just want to look at you, Lord.
Yeah.
In an adoring, loving way. What else does David says he wants to do? Not only gaze at the Lord's beauty, but what else? Before we get there, I listened to a pastor this weekend, and he said something that I had to add in here. He said that one reason, it wasn't in reference to David, but why we would want to gaze at the Lord's beauty is because we seek the blesser more than the blessings.
Amen.
I hope you got that. That means to seek the blesser. The Lord more than the blessing. Many of our prayers, we spend a lot of time begging and asking and requesting. But it says this gaze, this love for Jesus, he just wants to spend time dwelling with him in his house because he loves him. You know how it feels for somebody just to love you, not because of what you can give to them. Not because of what you have to offer them. They just love you. You know what that feeling is like? Somebody just love you for who you are.
Yeah.
This is what it's talking about with us falling in love like David with the Lord, gazing at him. Because we love him, not because of what he gives us, but just because of who he is. And what's the other verb there that David says he wants to do? Not only gaze upon the beauty of the Lord,
inquire in his temple.
That's right. So he wants to seek him. What does it mean to seek?
To know.
Again,
unless you go after.
Yeah.
You go after. When you seek something, you put out
chase effort. Him.
That's right. You put out effort. Seeking means to put out effort.
Yeah.
Like when you went and did your research, you had to put out some effort. You couldn't just sit there and it's going to come to you through osmosis. Okay? You seek to go after fervently because this is what I want. So I'm going to go after it. So here it says, he's not only going to gaze at the Lord's beauty because of whom he is, but or because of who he is, but because he wants to go after him in his temple, the place wherever God is. David wanted to be there. And so my wish for us is that wherever God is, we want to be there. We want to dwell in his presence, commune with him through fellowship. And we must have that longing to be constantly engaged with the Lord, to be constantly engaged with the Lord. And that is my wish for each of us this morning on this verse, that our one undivided aim would always be to stay in communion and fellowship with the Lord all the days of our life as we gaze at his beauty and we continue to seek him, because he must become for us our light, our salvation. And we seek him because he is the blesser more than the blessing.
Amen.
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 Okay, now we come back to plethora. If you have not had a chance to use your word yet, plethora, how about us hearing you use your word plethora now? Only those who have had a chance. Let's go.
I receive a plethora of knowledge and fun during this session.
Thank you.
Okay. So we are having a plethora of this coronavirus.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know if my daughter wants more dresses, isn't she already?
May I have my pen, please? I don't want to have my pen.
Jodiah.
Sorry, I was just talking to myself.
Yes.
Okay.
Mute your mic, man.
Huh?
Mute your mic.
Oh, I'm having a plethora of wine.
What?
What? She's drinking alcohol?
Non-alcoholic.
Great
juice.
Yeah. We know. All right. Go on, Shanique Taylor.
Shanique Taylor.
We've been acquiring a plethora of knowledge during these forums.
Thank you, Shanique. Who else? Mother Sharon.
Yes, behind Blanche, that's a plethora of colors as she combined the American and Jamaican flags.
All right. Anybody else who didn't get your chance to use your word?
Me.
Jalita, did you use it?
No, I don't see why my daughter wants more dresses when she already has a plethora of them.
Okay. All right, everybody. Marlon, you got your chance. I don't want to leave you out.
Yes, I did.
All right, good. So what's our new word?
Plethora.
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 Please, please use your words. And by the way, where's Naomi? Did we lose her?
Oh, my.
Did power go off again? They've been having power problems. Okay. All right. Plethora.
Suspense.
Yes. Oh, I'm hearing you. Where were you?
my device went off.
All right. You want to use plethora?
I just wanted to say that our sagacious children has a plethora of knowledge that she has imparted to us during these past several weeks.
Amen.
Thank you. I was just going to talk about you, but now I can talk about you to your face. She was showing off her plethora of knowledge, because each time she WhatsApp me, she uses every word to tell me what she wants to say. So I crowned her last week the valedictorian.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
I'm going to drink a little bit of my last lemonade to you, Naomi.
Lemonade?
Lemonade. That's what I had. What do I have in my hand?
bandana.
I have my trusty bandana. Everyone knows what bandana is?
Yes.
Amen.
Not until Corona.
Good. That means you know it. Take a bandana. You ready to write your project down? Make sure you take good notes. You may use one, two, just how many bandanas you want. I'm not limiting you to one, okay? I'm not limiting you to one. Create something from this bandana. Do not just do this. Please don't do this.
Why not?
Please.
I will finish quickly.
All right.
I want to be first.
I will send you back to the drawing board. Please don't send this to me. Okay? Create something from one bandana, two, three, four. And then you are going to take your video. Now listen carefully to your video because you are you are going to tell me in your video what you made. Okay? What you made from your bandana. What did you take? A plain bandana and recreate. What did you make? So your video will be telling me what did you make from your bandana. Now listen up. Make sure you're writing. Before you tell me what you made from your bandana, I want you to do this. When you stand up in front of your camera, whoever's video, taking a video of you, you're going to make a wish. Where would you like to go on holiday if it wasn't for this pandemic? Where would you like a special place you would like to visit? What would you like to see? I'm going to say it again. Make sure you're taking notes. Where would you like a place? Is your wish list, is in your bucket list, is something you've been dreaming about. If I could go to wherever I'd like to see. So you make that wish before, and after you make your wish, if I could go to wherever and this is what I'd like to see, then you tell me what you made from your bandana, and this is what I will take with me on my trip. Whatever you make, this is what you're taking with you on your trip if you had to go somewhere, wherever that dream wish is. Everybody's clear on that part because there's a little part I'm going to add to that. Everybody's clear? You wrote that down? If possible, and I know all of you going to do it because I'm so proud of you with your projects, get a lime green, write that color. It must be lime green tablecloth or sheet, plain, no flowers, nothing on it. It must be a plain lime green sheet or tablecloth and drape it. That's what I have at the back of me, a plain green screen. When you see these up here, it's a plain green screen I'm using. So it has to be lime green and drape it, fix it, and stand in front of your screen to make your wish and take your video. Stand in front of it. If you can't find lime green, remember, it can't have flower, nothing, plain, P-L-A-I-N, a plain lime green. If you can't find lime green, and then the second one would be royal blue. It can't be any blue, royal blue. Preferably lime green, if not royal blue. Or you can't find royal blue, get aqua. Any questions on your project? Remember, you have to stand in front of it, make your wish, your dream wish. Where would you like to travel to? Which place? What you want to do there, why you want to go there. Then tell me what you created from your bandana that you're taking with you on your trip. I'm interested to see you with this project as well. All right? And our technician will fix you up. does that. He fixes you up. All right. Let's go to our sing along. Every praise is to our God.
That's my song.
Singing along in your spaces, in your homes.
Every word of worship,
with one accord. every praise is to our God. Let's say Psalm 19, verse 14. Let the
words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, strength and my redeemer.
Amen.
Good week. We went over a little bit, but because this is me time, you don't mind. This is me time when we come together. That's right. That's what I call it for me and hope for you. May the Lord bless each of you as you segue now into your various tasks. Continue to be sagacious in your choice. Enjoy some Zephyr. And always have an appetency to come back to Let's Talk as you be fastidious, especially in this pandemic. And I know you have a plethora of stuff to do. So get to it, and I'll see you next week. And remember, Bandana Project on your screen. Thank you for all the kind remarks I see coming through on our chat. Thank you, Domika. She's at work and she's still paging in through phone. Thank you so much for your kindness, and have a blessed and safe week, both you and your families.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. And the same to you.
Okay. Bye-bye.